out there, it's yours truly, just doing another video, another upload to you guys out there on YouTube land. We just want to iterate something here for you, and I want to talk about this. This is called Toronto City Council, the Toronto and the East York Community Council. This is starting today, and folks, we are going to do this. I'm going to make this public out there, very much public, so I'm going to give a shout out to everything. This has to do with the Toronto and East York Community Council. I'm going to make this very public out there. And the YouTube channel is called Toronto City Council. That's a YouTube channel, and it's only got 179 viewers. That's 179 viewers, and streamed live 5 hours ago. That's right, folks. So, yeah, I'm gonna put this big title. I'm going to put the YouTuber's name at the beginning, and then put the title of their live stream thing. And I want to really announce it out there that this is actually happening, folks. Yeah, really. It's not only Donald Trump doing around the world. We got more things to deal with on YouTube. We got to give these people a shout out for these YouTubers out there doing their thing, doing their ultimate good, not the worst things that they do on YouTube. I'm going to call these people out. It's simply this. I'm going to call people out on YouTube channels and get them exposure that they desperately need, kind of thing. So I'm going to give the exposure the way they are. If it's deemed to be good or bad, doesn't matter. I'll put that out. If it's funny enough, I'll put it out as well. So it doesn't matter. If it's bad, good. It's kind of like the Clint Eastwood movie, bad, good, and ugly kind of thing. But this time, it's good, worst, great, thumbs up, laughable, in a good way. So we're gonna really, really emphasize this. Last night I was seeing this lady who was I won't tell you about it now, but I put up her name on one of my previous videos, and she was one of these United States people. They're not like vigilante or anything like that. They're out there, you know, pushing the idea that we don't all have to wear masks, we're all sheep. Yeah, I get it. She's a warrior or anything like that. Nothing to a sort. She's out there telling everybody this is actually happening kind of thing. This is what you call that. She's letting you know that the Capitol Hill, Washington D.C., Donald Trump, this has actually happened. And folks, it doesn't matter if it's a good way or a bad way. They're just pointing this stuff out, what's actually happening in the United States, what the so-called leaders around the world are doing. We've got to hold these people accountable. It's that tyranny stuff that you keep hearing about. Anyway, we are going to delve into this as much as possible. These are not warrior people. These are not out there vigilante and causing trouble and stuff like that. They're just pointing out what's actually happening in the United States. What you know, Donald Trump's trying to do to his Trump supporters, to just, you know, these are people walks of life, essentially that. Doesn't matter if they're a mother, daughter, son, doing this vlogging. It's just all walks of life, as I would say. Doesn't matter if you're mother, dad, sister, brother, have a YouTube channel. This is all having a YouTube channel. And sometimes there's usually the whole family is in the whole entire video. That sometimes happens too as well, like the Shaytards. You guys probably know that one. I don't need to get the details of that one. The whole family's in this whole thing, this whole YouTube thing. And but yeah, sometimes they do it individually. Sometimes they'll have their own YouTube channel, and they get their own videos out there, and they can do whatever they want. They create the content, they create the videos out there. It's for you to share and hit that subscribe button, as they would say, like YouTubers would say, and hit that like button. You know, they really mean that. They really mean that. They're not patronizing people out there. They really mean that. Hit that like button, subscribe to my channel. You know, all the stuff that YouTube tends you to do. It helps us get us views, it helps get us viewership, it helps get us subscriber base. You can share the videos, they keep saying, share the videos. And do what you have to do. If it needs to be you know, get it out there. Just get it out there. Just, you know, like last night, I was surprised this lady, she's kind of like a vlogger, I think, in a way. She's an older woman. You know, she's not like a teenager or something like that. An older woman. And she's out there, you know, in the United States, just telling everybody, this is what's happening. This is what happened to the mask. That we're not, this is so-called anti-masking. You know, it's like sheep to the slaughter, right? I think she put it in perspective there. It's like sheep to the slaughter. And she really, really told the police that this is all bad. This is all bad. You know, you people don't have to wear a mask. You know, they call them anti-mask people. They're out there saying that you don't have to wear a mask, you know. It's like sheep to the slaughter kind of thing. So you don't have to wear a mask. You don't have to go with vaccines, you know. These are people that read up the laws out there, the Constitution to the amendments, and really, really tell them what they think of it, you know. And these American citizens know the laws. I mean, upside and down of these laws. I mean, they cite them. They really tell you what they mean. In photographers, they'll tell you what that means as well. It means in public, you can take photos, videos in public areas. This is in public areas, not private areas. But public areas, it seems to be doable. Night and day, doesn't matter, night and day. Like photographers, they'll tell you what the amendments mean as a photographer. What areas you can go into. Public areas, you can go into public areas, you're allowed to do that. The police will even tell you that. So you don't need to worry. You don't need to be squeamish about it. As long as you're on sidewalks and sometimes the people get antsy that they think they're on their property, but they're not. They're on the sidewalks. So I get it with these people. I really do, folks. I really do. They're not on their property. Trust me. I've seen a lot of auditors out there. They're not on the people's people's properties. They're not. They know this. They know this for sure. They only go in public spaces, public areas. That's the only ways they can do it. The First Amendment gives them the right to film. So it's not like you have privacy or anything. When they go to public areas, you know, expect that. You know, these are just auditors. They'll tell you the First Amendment photography. But originally the other person would say, okay, if you don't get off my you-know-what, I'll call you-know-what kind of thing. They get a few people doing that, but that's okay. They can do that. They have, as they say, they have the right to do that. But we're on public sidewalk. The police will even come and they'll tell the other people, say, hey, this is okay. You're on the sidewalk. This is public sidewalk. You know the whole deal. And they just let you know. They let you know because from a law enforcement standpoint, they're allowed to do that. As long as they're on the sidewalk, they can do this. There's no privacy here, folks. But like I said, I don't expect a lot of people doing this. Just so you know, expect a lot of people doing this. But yeah, they'll let you know that this is the First Amendment auditors come and tell you that photography is not a crime at all, as long as you're in public spaces. So there you go, folks. You learned something here from my video, from my podcast. I don't need to tell you that. I've said this so many times on YouTube videos, and it comes crystal clear to me. It comes crystal clear to you people on YouTube. These are photographers. These are just, they're not annoying some. They're just, I know people think it's annoying some. But yeah, there's nothing you can do about it because they're on the public areas. They're not in private property areas. They can't go on. But people seem to wonder that they're on private property, which they're not. They're photographers, they're only allowed on sidewalks, you know. And I see this time and time again, as they would say. It's not an eyesore, it's not like a food. I see this time and time again on YouTube videos. Not many people are photographers and know this First Amendment photography. But just bear this in mind, you got the First Amendment. If you're an American citizen in the USA, you can do this. you can do this. Not many people can, just bear this in mind. Not many people can. You have to go out there and learn the laws out there in terms of photography. You know, what you can and cannot film kind of thing. In public kind of thing. But just be aware of that, folks. Just be aware of that and really get to know your knowledge when you're out there filming, okay? Because, you know, you don't want to get yourself in a tight situation, okay? Know the laws and be out there knowing what to say if people come up to and asking you what you're doing kind of thing and so on and so forth. Just let them know that I'm doing the First Amendment auditing on your so-called video camera. Whatever vlog camera you use, and let them know that this is just a First Amendment auditing photography, and I'm on public spaces, I'm not on your private property, it's on public spaces, police will tell you that, but yeah, this is for everybody in the United States and in Canada is a different laws here, this is for the charter rights to you name it. So if you're a U.S., if you have dual citizenship, you'll know the United States amendments and the Constitution and all that stuff. And don't forget, there's a called the Terry Law. They call it a Terry Law. I think it's called that. But these are the people behind the camera. They know all these laws before if someone were to ask them. And they always say what you're doing, and you say to them, well, I'm doing the First Amendment audit video for news. Yeah, so just let them know what you're doing, and that they know for sure what that means. Right, so, and it's okay. It's a protected. Apparently, it's a protected law. So there you go, folks. I'm going to leave you for now. And I almost forgot what was my original idea, but yeah, yes. This is a city council meeting. So you can watch this on YouTube, as they said. And yeah, I'm gonna title this for you folks, and here we go.